This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. Hey guys, Jannik here for Cinecam.net and welcome to another Copycat Friday, a weekly series where we recreate effects from famous movies and music videos. And this week we are doing something really crazy. Or let's say, it looks crazy. We are recreating the eye effect from Valentino Khan with his song Deep Down Low. This music video is one of my favorites of the last few years. The effects used in the music video are so weird, but are done extremely well. They fit perfectly with the song, making it a complete package. But to be honest, I never even heard of the song or saw the music video until some time ago. Back then, we started with a new series where we react to music videos, movie effects and other film related stuff. Now for this first episode of the React series, I thought to myself, let's go crazy. I started searching the internet for the weirdest music videos I could find. And guys, there's some weird shit going around on the internet. But the craziest thing on the internet is our sponsor Storyblocks Video. They have a huge stock video library that keeps on expanding. They offer a wide range of video assets from which you can download an unlimited amount. And this all for one single price per year. That's insane! If you want to start downloading right away, check out the first link in the description below. Now, eventually during my internet search, I came across Valentino Khan, and from the first time seeing it, I had to recreate it. But I wasn't the only one. Some of you had the same idea after seeing the React video. So without further ado, let's create the effect. The footage that you are going to need is quite simple. Just film your actor's head, and this can be quite close as you want to focus on the effect. You can also go handheld to keep it more natural.
Hey Lorenzo, what's going on?
What are you doing at the window, Lorenzo? Get back to work.
I'm just waiting for some candy from Japan, and it's super awesome. I got it, Jordi, look.
Lorenzo, stop playing around with your candy and come help me.
Lorenzo! What was in that thing?
What's he doing up there?
I have no idea.
Okay, now that you have your footage, let's go into After Effects. Drag your shot into a new composition. Now the first thing that we are going to do is stabilize the shot on the eyes to remove the handheld. I know, it sounds weird, because why the hell didn't we use a tripod then? Well, because we are going to use the reverse stabilization technique. This means that we are removing any motion from a shot. Without this motion, it's easier to add certain effects. And then when you are done with your effects, you can reintroduce the original handheld motion. Now with the reverse stabilization process, I'm not going to go in detail, because we just did a dedicated Creative Tuesday to the whole process. So if you want to learn more about reverse stabilizing your footage in After Effects, check out the link in the description below. In the Creative Tuesday video, we explain two different techniques you can use for reverse stabilizing your footage. For this effect, I'm going to go for the second technique. Basically, you can track your eyes in Mocha and enable the quick stabilization option. Then in After Effects, you can add the tracking data to your clip and invert it. For the next step, you can add the CC power pin effect to your shot. And with expressions, you can now parent the top and the bottom properties from the power pin effect to the Mocha properties. Keep in mind that it's very important that you match the right properties together. Otherwise, the stabilization won't work. But if done correctly, you'll now have a stabilized shot on your actor's eyes. So now we can start with the actual crazy eye effect. The first thing you want to do is copy the original layer twice. One to create a mask on and one for the mesh warp effect. You can also give them names to make it yourself easier. So like you can see, we are going to use the top layer to create a mask on. Take the pen tool from your toolbar on top and start drawing a mask around the eye you want to move. This mask can be quite rough and also needs to be feathered a bunch. After this, it's time to animate the eye. So enable the animation for the position property. Now move a few frames further in time and push the eye a little bit down. Let the eye rest here for a few seconds, then again create a keyframe for the exact same position. And as a last step for the eye, move a few frames further in time and copy and paste the first keyframe on that position. Now you'll have a masked out eye that moves down, stays there for a while, and moves back to its original position. The masking is done now, so let's continue with the mesh warp. Select the mesh warp effect and drag it to the middle layer. To make it ourselves easier, let's disable the top layer for a moment. Now select the mesh warp layer again and go to the effects controls. Here you can set the amount of rows and columns. Try to frame your actor's eyes between these rows and columns. This way you'll have the most control when mesh warping your eyes. For us, the amount will be 30 for the rows and 29 for the columns. After this, it's time to animate the mesh warp. So enable the animation for the distortion mesh on the same location as the first keyframe of the eye. Then go further in time to the second eye keyframe and start distorting. Through the mesh warp grid, you can now stretch your eyelids down. Here you can also enable the top layer back again. This will help you to determine how far you need to stretch those eyelids. After you have found the right stretch, go to the third eye keyframe and create a keyframe for the distortion mesh with the same exact location. Then with the last keyframe, just copy and paste the first one again. This will already leave you with the crazy eye effect. But we are still missing our original handheld motion, so let's reintroduce that. The first thing we need to do is create a mask on the mesh warp layer. Just create a rough mask around the actor's face. After this, select the mask and the mesh warp layer, right click on it and pre-compose them. Make sure that you enable the option Move all attributes into a new composition. This will leave you with a pre-composed layer and the original layer. Now reintroduce the handheld motion by selecting the original clip, then select the mocha and the power pin effect and press Ctrl X to cut the effects. After this, select the pre-composed layer and paste the two effects to the layer. The last thing you now need to do is check the unstretch box. And that is it, guys. With these simple few steps, you can make your actor go completely crazy.
Lorenzo! What was in that thing?
Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And like always, stay creative. Still not drinking coffee. Nope. It's still water. Let's do my warm-up exercises. I need to lubricate my voice.